We're going to draw the graph of the compound inequality x less than or equal to 4 or x greater than 3 and describe the set using interval notation. This is a compound inequality, and there are two types of compound inequalities. When two inequalities are joined by the word AND, the solution of the compound inequality occurs when both inequalities are true at the same time. It is the overlap or intersection of the solutions of each inequality. When the two inequalities are joined by the word OR, the solution of the compound inequality occurs when either of the inequalities is true. The solution is the combination or union of the two individual solutions. So the main thing to remember is for the word AND, we're looking for the intersection. For the word OR, we're looking for the union of the two intervals. So for the first step, we want to graph each interval on the number line. Let's first graph x less than or equal to negative 4. Notice negative 4 is in this interval, so we make a closed circle or closed point on negative 4. And because it's less than or equal to negative 4, we have an arrow to the left approaching negative infinity. This will be helpful when we give the interval notation. Now we want to graph x greater than 3. Notice 3 is not in the interval, and therefore we make an open circle or open point on 3. And because it's greater than 3, we have an arrow to the right approaching positive infinity. And now because we have the word OR, we're looking for the union or the combination of these two intervals, which means these two intervals are the solution to the compound inequality. And now we want to describe this set using interval notation. Because we have an interval on the left and on the right, we'll have two interval notations connected with the word or U for union. So the interval on the left would be all real numbers less than or equal to negative 4. So for interval notation, we'd have negative infinity, comma, negative 4. The interval includes negative 4. We have a bracket to the right of negative 4. And for negative infinity and positive infinity, we always use a random parenthesis. We have an open parenthesis to the left of negative infinity. And then we'll use U for union. Sometimes you'll see the word OR. And then we have the interval from 3 to infinity. So 3 comma infinity. 3 is not in the interval. So we use an open parenthesis to the left of 3 and a close parenthesis to the right of infinity. This is the graph of this solution. And here's the solution expressed using interval notation. One thing to be careful about, though, is that not all compound inequalities with OR will have a solution that looks like this. So let's look at a second example. The directions are the same, so let's first graph both inequalities on the same number line. So we'll first graph x greater than negative 2. Negative 2 is not in the interval. We have an open circle on negative 2, arrow to the right. So here's all real numbers greater than negative 2. Now we graph x less than or equal to 6. 6 is in the interval, so we make a closed circle or closed point on 6. And it says x less than or equal to 6. We have an arrow to the left. And again to the right, we're approaching infinity. To the left, we're approaching negative infinity. Now this is an OR compound inequality, so the solution is a union or the combination of these two intervals. And notice how every number on the number line is graphed at least once, which means the solution would be all real numbers. So to graph all real numbers, we graph the entire number line approaching positive infinity to the right and negative infinity to the left. So this first number line shows our work. This is the graph of our final answer. And now we need to express it using interval notation. So to the left we approach negative infinity, comma, to the right we approach positive infinity, and for negative and positive infinity, we always use a random parenthesis, so we have an open parenthesis to the left and a closed parenthesis to the right. This is how we express all real numbers using interval notation. So it is important that we're able to interpret what union means when graphing a compound inequality with the word OR. I hope you found this helpful.